Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Tartus Educational Platform. I am Ula Almoui, English Supervisor, Tartus Directorate, taking you through this session for the ninth graders. Our guests for today are Ms. Abir Jabour, Muhammad Harfouch School. Welcome, Ms. Abir.
Thank you.
Ms. Shaza Sabah, Bghamlih School. How are you, Ms. Shaza?
I'm fine, thanks. What about you?
I'm fine, thank you so much. Now, we're going to start with unit plan of unit number 3 from 9th and 9th grade Imar series. Let's start with you, Ms. Abir.
Okay, now we first have the reading part about life in the future and living in space.
Okay.
Then we move to vocabulary that are related to the text.
Right.
Then the grammar part is going to be about the future tense.
Okay.
In both parts, being be, going to, and will. Pronunciation then, short and long E.
Uh-huh.
The last part about writing, we are going to write a paragraph about one's life in 20 years' time.
Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Ms. Shaza, let's have a short summary of the reading part in the student's book. Short summary, please. Okay. About the main ideas.
Okay, now the text in the student's book talks about life in the future, how futurologists predict how life is going to be in many aspects of life, like
different fields, right?
In many aspects of life,
like what?
Teaching, health, farming,
technology, entertainment, okay.
Yes, everything. And now,
do people think that the future is going to be easy or difficult?
It's going to be easier due to technology, and
other people think that it might
be
difficult.
Troubling.
Next, please. Yes.
Now, in terms of teaching will be easier because e-books will replace traditional books.
Okay.
Robots will replace the teachers, and even absent students will have the chance to learn online because teaching will be online. Now, in terms of health...
Next, please. Yes.
In terms of health...
We're going to have, of course, improvements.
Improvements
in what fields
of life? Now, in terms of health, doctors will find more cures to the illnesses like AIDS, like
so cancer. New medicines are going to be found.
So people will live longer.
What about housing? We already have housing problems. Are we going to find solutions for these problems?
Sure, everyone
Next,
will
please.
Have a place to live because housing will be larger. And even in terms of farming, farmers will grow new seeds, like new crops, and
everywhere,
and even on the roofs of buildings.
So, are there going to be any hunger?
No, people will no suffer from hunger anymore.
Anymore, hopefully.
Hopefully, yes.
Next, please. Yes.
Now,
what about
leading to peace? Because people will live happier, will live longer. People will find more jobs, and will be no more hunger. So there will be peace
everywhere. Because everyone will get everything they need.
No fights, no wars anymore.
Okay, we hope for the best.
Yes.
But they are only expectations. So we can only hope.
Yes.
Thank you. Ms. Sabir, every unit has its own words, keywords.
Yes, keywords, yes.
Next, please. Okay.
Here we have the first one, futurologist, who is someone who forecasts the future based on existing conditions.
Right.
Predict, to say that something that will happen in the future.
Absolutely.
Aspects, areas, and fields. Replace. Take the place of, improve, make something better, crops, plants grown by farmers as food.
Okay.
These
now,
are the keywords of this lesson.
Right, thank you so much. Now we move on to the questions or the exercises of the book about this unit. We start with answer the following questions. Again, we have to mention that in the exam, students are not going to have open-ended questions.
Yes.
They're going to have multiple choice questions. Ms. Shaza, let's read the first one.
Okay, the first question, how does the writer see the future?
Okay, what about this, Ms. Sabir? What is the answer?
Okay, life in the in his opinion, his or her opinion, life will be more comfortable, and this will be.
So for some people, it might be comfortable.
Comfortable, yes, and some people will won't see that. Will be obvious in all aspects of life.
Okay, thank you so
much. In his opinion, yes.
Thank you. The next question, please, Ms. Abir.
Yes, number two, mention two things that will make education better.
Ms. Shaza.
E-books will replace traditional books, and everybody will be learning online, so even absent students will have the chance to learn.
Exactly. Thank you. Question number three, please.
Okay.
You can read it from the screen.
Question number three, will people live longer in the future? Why?
Okay, why?
First we say yes. Because,
why?
Okay, why? Because new medicines will...
Next, please.
Okay. New medicines are going to be... Will
help people get better,
yes.
And scientists and researchers are going to find cures.
New cures and medicines for diseases like AIDS and cancer.
Okay, thank
yes.
you so much. Question number three, please. Four, sorry.
Four. How will hunger stop all over the world?
How, Ms. Shazam?
People will grow new types of seeds and will grow them everywhere, even on the roofs of buildings.
Okay, thank you. And the last question is, will people live peacefully and why? Why?
I think when we have better education, mm-hmm. When we live longer, when we have
enough crops for everyone.
Yes, we will don't have to fight anymore.
There's nothing to fight
anything.
For.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. The last one is based on the students' own answer, so we don't need to write it down.
Very, yes.
And now we have kind of matching between the word and its meaning. Mm-hmm. To start with you, Ms. Sabir, the first one is?
The first one is obvious.
Okay. What do you mean by obvious?
Obvious, it means clear.
Clear. Okay. Next, Ms. Sabir, yes.
Yes, absent, the second word. It's... Not present.
Not present.
Yes.
What about peace, Ms. Shaza?
It's the opposite of war.
Uh-huh. And traditional means?
Old.
Thank you so much. Yes. Now we have an exercise for vocabulary that are mentioned in the text. For example, disease, peace, improve, predict, replaces, and obvious. Yes. To start with the first one, Ms. Abir.
Okay, the first sentence, it is difficult to... The missing word is predict.
Okay.
What the long-term effect of the accident
will be. Thank you so much. So the first one, predict. Ms. Shaza, the weather?
The weather will, towards the evening, the weather will improve.
Oh, improve or improved? There is no will. Improve, but it's okay. It can. Okay, thank you. Number three, Ms. Sabir.
Number three, his father suffers from a heart disease.
Heart disease. Thank you. And four, number four, Ms. Shaza.
The obvious way of reducing pollution is to use car less.
Okay, so we need to use car less because this is the obvious way. Number five, Ms. Sabir.
Number five, the country is at peace with its neighbors for the first time in years.
Uh-huh. And number six?
The new software package replaces the old one.
Thank you so much. Now, this is what we need to say about the first reading text in the student's book. If we move on to the activity book or workbook, Ms. Abir, can we have a short summary of Living in Space?
Yes, okay.
What does the text talk about?
The text is titled Living in Space.
Okay.
So,
are we going to be living in space in the future?
Some futurologists or scientists will think that we will. So by the end of this century, mm-hmm. there will be permanent settlements that will allow people to lead a normal life in space.
Right.
And hundreds of astronauts will go and live and work there.
Okay, maybe.
For at least 6 months. Uh-huh. Then they come back, and others will go and try living
so
there.
So we'll come and go regularly.
Yes,
okay.
Yes. It will be cheaper also to live on the moon.
Why?
Because
why would it be cheaper?
You don't have to bring everything you need from Earth
nice.
By rocket.
Uh-huh.
Okay. The settlement, the city will be like a huge, gigantic glass wheel.
Okay.
Okay. They get. It will have air. Also,
nice.
They don't need to wear a special space suit inside this buildings.
It's protected there?
Yes,
uh-huh.
Inside the buildings.
Nice.
And they will get water from an ice lake. there. Okay. We don't have to in the space city. Yes, we don't have to do housework anymore because robots will do this for us.
Nice.
Okay, nice.
I'd love to live in such a city.
Nice for moms and women.
Okay.
And then we don't need to eat or make food because they will take three uh-huh. times a day.
Good news.
Instead of meals. So this is the main idea of the text.
Okay, thank you so much. Again, we have keywords. Thank you so much, Ms. Abir. Again, we have keywords from the text. Ms. Shaza, what are these words?
Settlement, it means a new place to live in for large groups. Rocket, it's a vehicle used for traveling or carrying astronauts.
Uh-huh.
Gigantic, very big or huge. Obtain, get. Expedition, an organized journey with a particular purpose.
Thank you so much. Now again, we have questions to answer.
Yes.
Ms. Sabir, let's start with the first one. How will people live on the moon?
They will live easily and cheaply on the moon.
Okay, nice. Okay. Number two, Ms. Sabir, Ms. Shaza, how long will each group stay in the space city?
Actually, they will stay for 6 months.
For 6 months, and then we'll go back to the Earth.
Yeah, and okay. Another group will replace the old one until uh-huh. the 10 years are finished.
Okay, nice. Ms. Abir, when will people live on the moon? Is it soon?
They will live there by the end of the century.
Okay, nice. It's very soon. And number four, Ms. Shaza.
Where will people in the space take water from? They will take water from a large ice lake.
Nice. Thank you so much. Now we have true false questions. And Ms. Abir, do we have such a question in the exam?
Yes, we have an exercise that
yes, we do.
You
we
need
do
to answer true or false.
True
or
false. Yeah. Do they have to correct the information?
Maybe.
They are asked to.
Okay, but they're not going to be asked to. Most probably, they just need to decide is the statement true or false.
Okay.
Number one, please, Ms. Abir. Nowadays, it's possible?
Nowadays, it's possible for people to live on the moon.
Mm-hmm.
Nowadays, it's false.
It's
so
false.
Someday it is possible.
One day, yes.
One day,
Ms. Shaza, number two.
On the moon, people will have to wear special suits. No.
Is that correct? No.
No, it's false. People won't need to wear special suits.
They don't need to. Okay. And number three, Ms. Abir.
Astronauts will cook on the moon. No, it's false. They won't need to cook. Instead, they will take a pill three times a day.
Yes, you have just mentioned that it's good news for the moms. They
yes,
don't have
also.
To cook. Okay. And number four, Ms. Abir. Ms. Shaza, sorry to...
Robots will do the work. Uh-huh. For humans, it is true, and hopefully they will do.
Hopefully.
Yeah, now we have some...
The difficult word,
they
mean.
Do some work. Some
you mean
work.
The difficult words?
Yes, okay. Sometimes.
Okay, thank you. Next, please. Now let's move on to vocabulary. These are not exactly related to the text,
yes.
But they are important, a kind of family, maybe. Let's see with number one, Ms. Sabir.
It is normally or normal. To feel nervous before the exam,
okay.
The answer is normal.
It's normal, it's completely normal to feel nervous. Yes. Ms. Shaza?
Property in Homs is cheaper than property in Damascus. This is a comparative.
Okay, how can you tell that it's comparative?
You have than.
Than, so it is?
A comparative.
Cheaper.
So the answer is?
Cheaper.
Cheaper, thank you so much. Number three, Ms. Abir?
Number three, doctors gave Hani oxygen to help him breathe.
Breathe. What's the difference between breathe and breath?
A breathe is a verb.
A verb.
Breath is a noun.
Thank you so much.
So help him to breathe.
To breathe. Okay.
Yes.
Ms. Shaza, number four.
Number four. You will need to obtain.
Okay.
Permission from the teacher if you want to leave the class. You will need to obtain. We have the infinitive form after two.
Two.
Not obtained. Obtained. It's
not the simple past.
Yes.
Okay.
Or
past participle
or simple
yes.
past.
Yes.
And this is a cantative verb.
Yes. Thank you so much. Because we have two, so we choose obtain. Number five.
He has to take pills. The second word to control his blood pressure because pills. It means something you have to pay for.
So pills will cause him blood pressure.
Yes. Okay.
Thank you. Number six, Ms. Shaza.
Number six as well, like after two, we have to use the infinitive form. Our goal is to establish a new research center in our city. We have to establish.
And establishment is?
Establish to build a new thing.
Okay. I mean, establishment is a noun. right? It's not a verb. Here in this sentence, we need to use a verb.
Yes, we need to use establish. A verb. Establish is the verb and establishment is the noun.
Thank you so much. You've been a great help. Now, Ms. Sabir, this is an example. Before we move on to grammar, we need to have these sentences, some from the text and others are not, just to clarify the idea of the grammar we're going to have. Yes. Let's answer these questions, which are multiple choices, the same way they're going to have in the final exam. Yes. Number one, please.
Number one, futurologists predict that life probably be very different in all the fields of life.
Uh-huh.
So the multiple choices are will, is, being, was. The true answer is will.
Of course.
Because
will
it's
probably be. Will,
yes,
probably,
will probably
be. Thank
be.
You so much. Ms. Sheza, scientists and researchers
are going to find
are cure going to find
for many diseases like AIDS and cancer.
Okay, because they are working on it now. So yes, we have kind of a proof that they are going
evidence
to find.
Evidence or proof.
Evidence.
So we use be going to and here are going to find.
Thank you so much. What about number three?
Number three, I think that life in the future will be easy and comfortable. So the answer is D.
Uh-huh.
Will be.
Will be. Thank you. Number four, world peace. Ms. Sheza.
Will spread. I'm expecting.
Uh-huh.
Is, will spread
will
everywhere.
Spread. Can we use spreading?
No.
When spread. Well, grammatically speaking, it is possible, but logically, no. It's not happening
because
so far.
We're expecting only.
Okay. Yeah. It's not happening now, so we cannot use present continuous. Let's move on to the next part. Next, please. Okay. Ms. Sabir, number five.
Number five. I'd love to go out, but I think it will continue raining.
It will continue raining.
Yes.
Thank you so much. Ms. Sheza, number six.
Number six. It's freezing today. It is going to snow. Because we have an evidence.
Evidence.
It's freezing today, so we use be going to predict something in the future.
Absolutely.
Based on evidence.
Absolutely. Thank you. Number seven.
Number seven. I think our team will win the match. Mm-hmm. It's a prediction.
Prediction.
No.
I think. Evidence. As long as
I
we
think.
Have think, it
we
is.
We don't have an evidence.
Okay. Number eight, please.
Number eight. Tonight we are going to have a birthday party for mother. We have a plan. We are planning to do, we have
Thank
intentions.
You. Okay, intentions or planning. We are planning for something and intending to have a party.
Yes.
And the last one, Ms. Sabir.
It is a heavy box. I will lift it for you. It's a decision that we made at this moment.
Thank you
moment.
So much. So as I have just said, this kind of an introduction to our grammar for today, which is the future tense.
Yes.
Let's start with you, Ms. Sheza. When we use the future tense, what are the two types, if we can say, or the two forms of future tense?
Will and won't.
Of course, we have different forms. We use it with present continuous and present simple, but we're not going to talk about them today. Today, we're going to discuss will.
And be going to.
And be going to. Thank you so much. Let's start with will.
Yes. We use will when we predict something in the future, but we don't have any evidence.
Uh-huh.
In comparison to be going to, we use be going to when we have an evidence. So I predict something in the future based on an evidence.
Okay, thank you so much. Next side, when you, what next do we
will,
use? Why?
I use will when I make a decision at the moment of speaking. But I use be going to when I have already decided that I'm going to do something in the future.
Okay.
I intend, I have an arrangement. Like,
thank you so much. So with will, before we move on, before we speak about the use, can you please give me just an idea about the form of will?
Okay. First we start with the subject,
mm-hmm.
will, and an infinitive form of the verb.
Infinitive form without to, of course.
Without to.
Okay.
For example, I will have tea.
Mm-hmm.
I think I will have tea.
I think I will have tea. Or do you need tea? I will do some. For example, thank you so much. Ms. Abir, so with will, we need no evidence. What about going to?
Going to, we have predictions of the future, but we have evidence.
Evidence. Can you give me an example, please?
Yes. Look at the clouds. It's going to rain.
Uh-huh.
So it is going to rain because I saw the clouds in the sky. It's an evidence that it's going to rain after a while.
Okay, other than having evidence with will, it is a decision taken at the moment of speaking with going to.
Now, it's a plan. We planned it before to do something in the near future, like we are going to have a party for mm-hmm. my mom, like we said before. We planned to do it.
So plans or intentions?
Intentions, yes.
Thank you so much. Let's have examples from the book to make things clearer as much as possible. Ms. Shazza, the first one, Amal.
Amal has bought a new book tonight. She is going to stay at home and start reading it. So Amal is planning to read it since she has got the book.
Yes, she's got a book, so there is a plan, there is an intention, so the answer is going to. Thank you so much. Ms. Sabir, the second one, it's ringing.
The phone is ringing. I will answer it because I took the decision at the moment of speaking. Yes,
thank you so much. A decision taken at the moment of speaking when the phone started ringing. Thank you so much. Number three, Ms. Shazza.
Number three, I'm not free tomorrow. Mm-hmm. I'm going to see the doctor. So I have a previous appointment.
Of course, you had an appointment, of course.
I plan to see the doctor.
Thank you so much. Number four.
Number four, we forgot to buy bread. We will go back to buy someone.
Again, some.
Yes, it's a decision made at the spur of moment.
Yeah. Thank you so much. And the last one, Ms. Shazza, sorry.
Number five, she's so tired, she needs some rest. I think, we have think, so no evidence. I think she will take a week off.
Okay, thank you so much. And of course, we have the answers on the screen, as always. Now, this is a different type of questions when they have the verb between brackets and we need to complete the sentences with will or going to based on the sentence. Let's start with you, Ms. Abirs. Number one.
Number one, do you want to go with us next Saturday? The answer, we are going to attend a football match.
So since I'm inviting you.
So we are planning we have intentions to do this.
We have plans to do it.
Yes.
Okay. Yes, Ms. Shazza.
The weather will be dreadful tomorrow.
Okay. This is, of course.
Protecting.
Okay. Protecting. Protection. We are expecting. There is no proof. Okay, no evidence. So will be. Number three, Ms. Sabir.
Number three, I will lift that heavy box for you mm-hmm. because I saw you carrying...
I decided
to help you.
Exactly.
Yes.
This is at the moment of speaking. I saw you having effort carrying the box, so I'm offering my help.
I decided to help.
Thank you so much. Number four.
Tonight we are going to have a birthday party for our mother again. We have a plan. We have arranged to have a party.
Thank you. Okay, and I think, as long as I have, I think.
Yes, it's a prediction with no evidence. I think our team will win the match.
Thank you so much. So this is it for the grammar section. Let's move on to have just an idea, just to make things easier, maybe to pronounce with the pronunciation section, because they are very important. We need to mention them now. We have E, it's long E or short one.
Yes.
Ms. Shazza, I'm going to start with you with the short E. Can you please pronounce the words with the short E?
Okay. Men, read, met, led, set, fell, wet, hell, tem, peck.
Thank you so much. So this is short E. This is short E. What about E?
E, the long Ms. E. We have examples. Mean, read, meet, lead, seat, feel, wheat, heel, teen and peak.
Okay, so they can differentiate between the two words with short E and long E, like men, mean.
Yes.
There is the difference between A and E. Thank you so much. Now we move on to the writing part. Of course, in the writing part, we have different kind of questions. It might be that students need to choose the mistake from four choices, or they have to reorder sentences to make a paragraph.
Yes.
This is an example we have today. We have a paragraph that is not ordered. We need to reorder it to make a paragraph. Let's start with you, Ms. Shazza. Reorder the following sentences to form a paragraph. It's about my life in 20 years' time.
Okay, in 20 years' time, I will be over 30 years old.
Mm-hmm.
I will be married, and we will have two children. I will have a good job. I will be an English teacher because it's my favorite subject. We will have a nice house, but it is not going to be very big. We will spend a lot of time playing with our children. I'm interested in music, so I will have a wonderful music collection. We will only get our music from the internet. I will play traditional folk songs very well because I'm learning them now.
Thank you so much. So, when students are reordering the paragraph, they have to think about the introduction. Here, with this introduction, I can start, I will be an English teacher. This is not a good introduction. And it can be in 20 years, okay, this is a good introduction. So we start about telling you what I'm going to talk about. So it is in 20 years' time, I will be over 30, etc. So this is an introduction. Yes, then they have to fix the sentences together. Yes. And here is an example. Thank you so much. Again, we have the text ordered and ready to be written. Let's say order. So this is one type of the sentences or questions they might have in the exam. The other type is free writing. Yeah. So they need to write. We give them a question to write about, and we need to give hints. In this unit, what kind of paragraph are they going to write about? Next, please.
Imagine how your future house will be and write a paragraph about it. So they are going to write a paragraph about his their imaginary house in the future.
Okay.
What will be, and describe it for us.
How are they going to order the paragraph or distribute the information they have? First of all, they should do kind of brainstorming.
Yes, they should decide about what they are going to write.
Uh-huh.
So start with an introduction, a sentence to tell us what we are going to read. Then their ideas about their house, the future house, and describe it. And then the conclusion about their opinion about this.
Maybe hopes.
Yes.
Okay, hoping that this is going to be true in the future.
Okay.
Ms. Shaza, do you have anything else to add? Information might be included in such
like
paragraph?
Like names, physical appearance, dates.
Next, please.
Background information. Mm-hmm. And any other categories.
So, in such paragraph, first of all, we need to pay attention to have an introduction.
Yes.
To make the reader understand that you're going to write about this topic. Then we have the body or supported ideas. For example, I'm going to write about my house. My house in what way? Are we going to talk about the building, the services in the building?
No,
so we need to include details. Like name, with the house we don't have a name or physical characteristic.
Numbers,
we can have characteristic of the house.
Yes.
Numbers, like numbers, numbers, yes,
rooms,
yes. About the house, so it's about the building, the services I'm going to have in the building, color maybe, many things. They can talk about anything in the house. And of course, when you categorize the information, you're going to have your supporting ideas. And we end the paragraph with
The conclusion. Which repeats the introduction in other words.
Yes.
Paraphrase the introduction.
The whole paragraph,
the introduction and the body. Because students need to stick to the same ideas. Don't bring something new in the introduction.
Exactly. In the conclusion.
In
the conclusion, we don't bring anything new. That's for sure. Okay. Anything else to add?
Yeah, I want students to follow the chronological order in the paragraph. Stick to the same points, as I mentioned before, and use the transition words.
Like what? Can you give us an example?
Yes, like first, second. Uh-huh. When they bring the last idea.
When we have a process.
That, yeah. Don't say last. Say last but not least.
Uh-huh.
This is a good point for
okay.
the last aspect we mentioned.
Mm-hmm. Thank you so much. Ms. Sabir, do you have anything else to add about the writing?
No.
Okay.
She said it
okay.
all.
Now let's have a simple recap of the main points discussed today about unit number 3. We started with
The reading text
okay.
about the future.
Okay.
We read the text and then we answered comprehension questions
mm-hmm.
about it
uh-huh.
With true or false also. Then we did the vocabulary, yes, the new keywords.
Mm-hmm.
And then the grammar part.
Okay, what about the grammar part, Ms. Shaza? What did we have in
we
grammar?
We discussed the future
mm-hmm.
With the will, or be going to.
Mm-hmm. After that, we
did the
pronunciation part
and then the writing part.
Okay, thank you so much. So this is it for today. Thank you, Ms. Sabir Jabour, Muhammad Harfouch School. Thank you so much, Ms. Shaza Sabah. Thank you so much for being with us today.
Okay.
Thank you. We will meet again with more units to discuss. Thank you for watching us. This is Ulan Mui, English supervisor. Stay safe and happy. Thank you so much.